Hi everyone, for this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make it look as if you're writing out some copy. So in this, I'm going to just click on the text tool, and you can see I've made a new composition here. It's 1920 by 1080, and I'm just going to type in something random. I'll just do Rollins here, and I'm going to make this pretty big just to show you how to do it, but you can always, of course, just zoom in to make it smaller if you want to. If you want to have just, let's say, a lower third or something right on the text. So here I've got this Rollins piece here, and this is actually a pretty easy effect. It's very similar to highlighting text or making a line graph. We're going to use the stroke effect. Now, to do that, we are not going to make a new solid. In fact, what we're going to do this text layer as basically a solid. And you can see that there's a lot of different applications for this. But of course, you want to use something that looks like script. I've used Viner Hand here, but there's many others, Papyrus, etc. And then I'm just going to go to Effect, and then Generate, and then Stroke, just like you would normally do here. You're going to need to really mess with your brush size and all of this, but at this point, I don't want to worry about that. What I do want to do is go ahead and make my path or my mask. And I want to follow this in the same way that I would do this if I was writing it out. So you can do this multiple masks, but in this case, I'm going to simply start. I would go up, and then let's say down and over here. And then I might go back up and go in edges here. So you can see that I'm actually going a little further than I would normally go. What I'm trying to avoid is overlapping other bits of this with these edges. I really want to make this look as if I'm starting off. You can actually adjust these individually here. So you can see that I just made a mistake there. I closed my mask, but I was too close to this. So I want to do is really start a little further away, and then I can adjust this in. You can adjust these to make it look like there's a curve as well, by holding down Alt, and then you can actually curve this edge around if you choose to make it look like it's actually a going in a circle as opposed to these straight edges, and that often works really well. So what I'm going to do is just keep clicking here, and again trying to make this look to overlap it as much as I can, but to really follow what I would do if I were writing by hand. And you can see with this little dot here for the eye, that might be a little difficult. But basically, you're just following these curves and use as many points of the path as you need to make this look exactly the way you want it to look. And like I said, if you were to do a really detailed job here, you probably would go ahead and make curves instead of having a bunch of little points here. But you get the idea. This is all one mask. So once this is done, you want to go back through and have it follow your mask one. If you use multiple masks, let's say there's multiple little pieces, let's say there's an exclamation point or something you'd want to have as a separate mask, then you would say usually all masks and strokes sequentially. But in this case, I just want mask one. So I'm going to go ahead and have this reveal my original image, and you can see that everything seems to disappear. So what I need to do is to go ahead and oops, go ahead and increase my brush size, and you can see that as I increase this, it reveals more and more of the piece, and that's about enough. That's all I need. And you might want to play with this. You might actually want to animate your brush size. Let's say if you come in a little bit too close here and it starts to reveal part of the other piece here. So this is finished. I'm going to go in around 2 seconds. I'm going to animate my endpoint, and then I'm going to go back to the beginning, and I'm going to reduce this down to 0%. So as I scroll up, so I can press spacebar, you can see that it basically looks like it is writing the piece on. It's actually a pretty nice effect and really surprisingly simple. Good luck.